During the final months of World War II, Allied forces, in their advance through Germany, discovered a secret facility hidden 100 miles from Frankfurt. Allied intelligence believes that inside lies a revolutionary weapon that could change the course of the war. The Horten 229, a jet-powered flying wing whose structure was primarily made of wood. The Horten Ho 229 was a revolutionary flying wing jet fighter designed by the Horten brothers in Germany during World War II. With a wingspan of 55 feet, 16.76 meters, and a length of 24.5 feet, 7.47 meters, its design eliminated the need for a conventional fuselage, reducing air resistance and improving maneuverability. It was powered by two Junkers Jumo 004B2 turbojet engines, which allowed it to reach a top speed of 607 miles per hour, 977 kilometers per hour, and a service ceiling of 49,200 feet, with an operational range of 620 miles. Its structure, primarily composed of wood with composite materials, gave it an empty weight of 8,800 pounds and up to 17,600 pounds at maximum takeoff, while also providing a degree of radar signature reduction, making it a precursor to stealth aircraft. Its armament consisted of two 30 million Malawian kwachas, 108 cannons, and it could carry up to 2,200 pounds of bombs, making it a versatile fighter bomber. With a single pilot crew, the Ho 229 represented a significant technical advancement. Allied troops discovered an aircraft of unusual appearance at the Oranienburg facility. Its design, its structure, and the documents found only increased the mystery. What kind of machine was this? That enigma began months earlier, in the early morning of December 18, 1944. Pilot Erwin Ziller watched as ground personnel pulled the fighter out of the hangar. Its avant-garde silhouette contrasted with the morning fog. It was a historic moment. The first flight of a jet-powered flying wing was about to begin. The Horten Ho 229 was an innovative flying wing aircraft designed in World War II, whose structure eliminated the conventional fuselage and vertical stabilizers, reducing aerodynamic drag and improving flight efficiency. Its fuselage was primarily constructed of plywood, reinforced with laminated wood spars and ribs, a decision influenced by the scarcity of metals in Germany. Additionally, it was coated with a mixture of charcoal and resins, which has led to speculation about its potential capacity to reduce radar detection, making it a precursor to the stealth concept. Unlike other jet fighters like the Mi-262, the Ho 229 integrated its two Junkers Jumo 004B2 engines within the wing structure, optimizing aerodynamics. Its cockpit, with a bubble canopy, improved pilot visibility and reduced air resistance. It also featured a retractable tricycle landing gear, which improved ground stability. The design has been studied in modern times, with analyses conducted by Northrop Grumman and the Smithsonian National Air and Space Museum, which concluded that its structure could have reduced radar detection compared to other aircraft of the era. The roar of the engines breaks the morning silence. Erwin Ziller, an experienced test pilot, accelerates and begins takeoff. The first flight is completely successful. The test flights continue, and Ziller is in charge of carrying out each one. It's February 1945. The right engine catches fire. He tries to recover, but while doing so, he loses complete control of the aircraft. A flash on the horizon. The Horten 229 has crashed. Smoke rises in the cold dawn. Erwin Ziller is dead. Had the Horten Ho 229 entered combat, it would have posed a threat to Allied bombers due to its high speed, 607 miles per hour / 977 kilometers per hour, and potential stealth capability, making it difficult to detect and intercept. Its aerodynamic efficiency would have allowed for greater range than other jet fighters, such as the Mi-262, and its innovative design gave it an advantage in rapid hit-and-run attacks. However, its impact would have been limited by production problems, a lack of trained pilots, fuel shortages, and potential stability issues due to its flying wing design. Although it could have complicated Allied bombing raids over Germany, the Allies' numerical and logistical dominance would have prevented it from changing the course of the war. Amidst the chaos of the war's final months, Allied troops are working against the clock. They know time is running out. They cannot allow this technology to fall into Soviet hands. The order is clear. Disassemble, pack, and transport everything they can. Under Operation Paperclip, the Horten 229 is secured and loaded onto a ship bound for the United States. Its avant-garde silhouette, ahead of its time, presents an enigma for the engineers who will soon study it. This unique machine will not only remain in the archives of history, but will also drive the development of future stealth aircraft. More than just a prototype, the Ho 229 was special, visionary, and, above all, an engineering marvel. Thank you for watching the video. I invite you to subscribe to the channel. Until next time, in a new Weiss video.